Also, brand new White House reaction to a wave of immigrants flooding into our southern border. This crisis is now being felt all around the country, and political pressure is building for the feds to do something about this situation. The White House says the president has no problem going it alone, once again saying that he will use his executive authority if Congress won't.
These are all very difficult policy problems. The real shame of all this is that the Senate has acted in bipartisan fashion to address many of these problems. So what the president has said is, let's look for ways, since House Republicans have signaled that they are going to block that Senate legislation, that common sense bipartisan agreement. The president has said, what can we do using only my executive authority to try to address some of these challenges? That's what the lawyers are hard at work on.
The lawyers are hard at work on figuring that out. Simon Rosenberg is the president and founder of think tank NDN and a former Clinton campaign advisor. David Avella is the president of GOPAC. Gentlemen, welcome. Good to have
good to
you here.
You.
So what exactly, Simon, do you think the president would do in this situation if he is forced to, as we just heard from Josh Earnest, go it alone? What does that mean?
Well, I hope we don't get to that point. I think what the president's saying is we've passed a good bill on immigration reform out of the Senate. We've also now put forward what they call a supplemental, which has additional things that we need to do to help bring this border crisis to a close. The ball's in Congress's court now. He's made his moves. It's time for Congress to act. And I'm optimistic that Speaker Boehner will be able to bring the Democrats and the Republicans together in the House and get something meaningful done.
To do the $4 billion? Much of which does not go to sort of a long-term answer, many would say, for actual border security and making sure that this, you know, doesn't continue to happen.
No, I think that what Democrats want is both passing comprehensive immigration reform, which has passed the Senate, and moving ahead on this supplemental. We think those two things together will go a long way to solving this current crisis.
David, what do you think?
Well, it is pure political spin because this would not have addressed the hundreds of the thousands that are coming across the border right now. Had the president been serious about putting up the fence along the southern border, that's what would have prevented this. And in 2009, the GAO came out and said it would cost us about $6.6 billion to build the fence. The president's now asking for $3.7 billion to solve the problem that wouldn't have been a problem had we had the southern border built when Congress approved it and they started moving on it years ago.
You know, there's so many I guess the president's leadership is one of the big questions here, Simon.
Sure.
It feels once again that the White House has been caught off guard by the situation, and they're scrambling to play catch-up, and they're saying, well, now, Congress, you better do something about it. But where is the sort of overall presidential mission of saying, okay, listen, here's what we're going to do. We're going to stop the staunch of travel this way. In terms of the people who are here already, I'm going to do A, B, and C. There are governors who are saying that there are people coming on buses to their states, and no one from the federal government even told them they were coming.
I think the president has been very aggressive about laying out his plan. I mean, it's both comprehensive immigration reform and it's a supplemental. And I think one thing that's very important to recognize is under George Bush, the undocumented population in the U.S. increased by over 3 million people. We saw a huge increase. Under Barack Obama, there's been no increase in the undocumented population in the United States. The flow has been stopped. The people who are coming to the border,
well, apparently
we're catching.
You know,
we're
there's
catching.
Some very creative
no,
ways that that's
Martha.
Being counted as well,
no,
Simon,
no, no,
which
no,
has
no,
been...
No, no. No, no,
Simon,
absolutely not.
Simon, the
president's
economy has made it a lot less attractive for folks to want to come to this country, given the policies of this administration and trying to
create jobs. The economy's done far better under Barack Obama than it did under George Bush, so that's a nice try.
That doesn't matter. If you're a mom or if you're a child who's alone right now on this border, every one of us feels compassion for these children who made this arduous journey. Many of them are lucky to have even survived it. And I think the question is, where's the plan? And you can tell me that it's going to take $4 billion. But my question would be, it's always a huge amount of money. That seems to be the answer for every problem. Where is the sort of overall mission and understanding? Look, this is who we are. These are the borders we're going to put down. This is who's allowed in. This isn't who's allowed in. If a law needed to be changed, why did we have to wait for an emergency like this to make that happen, Simon?
The Democrats have been trying to change the immigration laws for 9 years. The Republicans have been blocking them for 9 years. We've been saying the system has been broken for 9 years. We've been putting solutions. The only thing the Republicans want
to
do is deport the kids. All they're saying is we're going to deport the kids.
So David,
that's the only answer.
Democrats
we've got to get more from the Republicans.
Have come up with all these answers, and it's you folks that have caused all of the problems. Why don't you solve this problem then, David?
Well, it starts with securing the border. What Simon is advocating is that we have no policy on immigration. We have a policy right now that says if you want to rush the border, you get to come to America because of our humanitarianism. But if you are an educated, highly skilled worker, when your visa's done, you must go home. This is a fractured, at best, immigration policy that does no,
it's
shows
no, policy,
no leadership.
Because anybody who wants to walk across that border in this situation from these three countries
exactly.
can do it. Because the border guards
Martha,
aren't at the
true.
Border.
That's
they're
not true,
in
Martha.
From
that's
the
not
border,
true.
And there are areas
that's
that they can
true.
Never cover.
And in fact,
right,
we've been deporting tens of thousands of adults.
David, what's
we've been
not
deporting
true,
tens of thousands of adults from these three countries over the last 3 years. It's the kids, because of a Bush era law, that we have different restrictions on what we can do in a humanitarian way to deal with these poor children who are coming into the country.
Which means they're allowed to cross. But
and Simon, why hasn't the president addressed that in legislation, which he said he was going to do, but didn't when he asked for the authorization for more money last week?
I think
so
what he said is that we are very open. The Democrats are very open to changes. We're waiting for the Republicans to
you
respond
didn't offer
to
them
our
last
offering.
Week.
Well,
you're
right. The president has yeah. said that he wanted to change the legislation, and then the White House backed off on that a bit, and that's where we are today, which is yeah. a mess, essentially, and,
right.
and a lot of children that need some sort of answers and a nation that needs a plan. Simon, thank you. David, thank
sure.
you.
Thank
sure.
you.
All right, so meanwhile, Fox News...